As the recession bites ever deeper, we're all on the lookout for a bargain. And with the euro so strong, southerners in their droves are choosing to shop up here. But now their politicians are telling them in no uncertain terms that it's their patriotic duty to keep their spending in the Republic. Julia Paul checks out this latest cross-border battle.
Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler, if you think we're on the run?
In the battle to save money, the shoppers' invasion used to be south. But now sterling is in retreat, the euro is on the rise, and the shoppers are advancing north. Which means that here in Londonderry, if you're dealing in euros, business is booming.
This particular year, especially in recent months, we're beginning to notice a large number of customers coming in from Donegal and further afield. We would give a very preferential, almost a preferential rate. At the moment, the market rate's about 82, and I would say, very close to changing our rate up to 85p, which is very, very attractive, considering this time last year it was 75 or even 70p that many retailers would have given for a euro. That's a big, big difference in the spending power and people coming across the border.
But funnily enough, this exodus isn't going down well with politicians in Dublin.
We've enough problems with people going to Northern Ireland for many goods and services, which has made things very difficult preparing this budget, I can tell you, because there is a huge loss of revenue to Northern Ireland because of all the purchases that are taking place there.
Dan Corley, it is no less than a call to patriotic action. It is my great honour to commend this budget to the House.
In the past, you were asked to die for your country. We're asking people to buy for their country this Christmas. The same people that will be nipping across the border to do their shopping this Christmas will be at home next February, March and April complaining that their sons and daughters have been let go in their jobs. So what we're asking people to do this year is, you know, if they even spent, you know, 10% of their spend on Irish products, it will go a long way to sustaining employment in Ireland, which is really what we want to do, you know, during the recession.
What is it?
Patriotic duty, another state? I thought we were in this recession together. Certainly, the biggest all-Ireland party isn't impressed.
I think it's short-sighted. I think it's populist. I think it will not make any material difference to the economic well-being of people who live in the border areas. And I also think that ordinary people struggling to survive in these economic climates will look for the best deal. They will look for the best bang for their buck, even if that is a reducing commodity. But they'll travel across the border if that is the thing to do.
Of course, the border has always played a role in times of economic adversity. These days, it's fuel that's smuggled up from the Republic. But during the Second World War, it was butter. But in today's climate, if one side is winning the war against the recession, the other side is losing. Here in Letterkenny, just 25 miles from Derry, but in the Eurozone, they're feeling the pinch.
Well, you can see our main street here is quite busy, but I mean, traders are saying it's similar last year, it's a bit flat. You know, we would want to see it progressing a bit quicker for Christmas. So it's not buoyant. We are leaking people over the border, and We were kind of used to that with the exchange rate before, but it's a bit more stark this year.
You can still be patriotic, but like, forget you're in a recession. You're going to go where it's going to be cheaper, and it is cheaper in the north. So,
my dad actually works in the north, and he's making the sterling there. The exchange rate's gone to pot. So, you know, I mean, it only makes sense for us to spend our money in the north.
So, depending which side you're on, living by the border can have benefits. But what about the effects further afield? Last year, cross-border trade was worth 3 billion euro. But with recession looming, is there a danger that the border will once again become an economic barrier?
For many years, the two parts of this island almost turned their backs on each other in terms of the economy. Not even sort of going back the last 30 or 40 years, going back right to the partition. And all what we've been doing in Great Ireland is actually to bring the two parts of the island more close together, looking at different ways in which they can collaborate in the good times, in the Celtic Tiger boom, a lot of companies, particularly in the south, didn't really see any great value in looking north and looked to Europe, looked to the States, looked to GB. And now they're actively coming, unsolicited, to us to ask us to get them introductions to large companies in the north.
And Intertrade is also encouraging businesses to collaborate over research and development through the Innova project. This software company in Letterkenny has teamed up with a uniform manufacturer in Derry. They've developed a unique uniform to fight hospital-acquired infections.
We can now go into the healthcare market and offer the entire solution. Before that, we could only offer one part of that. So from a point of view of showing the depth of our capabilities, it's been great. And to be able to offer the complete solution, it's been paramount.
The funding that Intertrade have provided us was essential to a pure R&D project like this. Small to medium enterprises like ourselves just wouldn't have had the level of funding available to us to invest in something so proactive.
You've got 45 seconds to clear off, starting now.
In the stampede to save money, it's each jurisdiction for itself. It might be last one over the border, turn off the Christmas lights.